The day we have all been waiting for has finally arrived. Tonight is night number one of the two-night Democratic Party presidential debates, and this is a really big deal because this is the first debate. This will set the stage for the rest of the primaries. This will make or break candidates, and I'm absolutely excited. I'm ecstatic about this. I actually was having trouble sleeping last night because I was thinking about the debates. So this is a big deal. This is, you know, the playoffs. This is the Super Bowl. Or maybe the election itself is more like the Super Bowl. Maybe I shouldn't have invoked a sports analogy when I know nothing about sports. So disregard everything I just said. Doesn't matter. Let's talk about what we can expect tonight. So here's what I think is going to happen. There's probably going to be one breakout star. I don't know who that's going to be, but this will be based not necessarily on policy substance, but it will be based on performance. Who can basically get their message across and do it in a really forceful and persuasive way. Now, here's what I really want to see happen. This is on my wish list. First of all, I want everyone to punch left. I'm rooting for Elizabeth Warren and Tulsi Gabbard. I want both of them to punch left. I want Elizabeth Warren to hit these corporate Democrats on stage, like Cory Booker, like John Delaney. And when it comes to Tulsi Gabbard, she really needs to get her name across. How could she do that? What, in my view, would make me feel satisfied if she just came out and pulled no punches and she hit Elizabeth Warren because of her wishy-washiness on Medicare for All. So if Tulsi Gabbard said, look, I'm the only candidate on this stage who has been consistent when it comes to the issue of Medicare for All. Elizabeth Warren claims to be a progressive, but she's been wishy-washy on this, and now she's talking about many paths to Medicare for All. Which is it? Do you want someone who doesn't even have a healthcare plan that they're absolutely behind unequivocally, or do you want someone who's been consistent? If she did that, that would be huge, and it would force Elizabeth Warren to be introspective and actually take a stand and stop sitting on the fence. I also want to see Tulsi hit everyone on foreign policy. You've got some warmongers on that stage. Now, they're not warmongers in the neocon sense, but they have pushed for escalation between the United States and Russia. They've pushed for intervention, maybe not militarily, but intervention nonetheless when it comes to Venezuela. I want her to hit them on that. I want Elizabeth Warren to call out these people who aren't taking bold policy approaches. I want her to call out John Delaney and ask him why he's not in favor of regulating Wall Street to the extent that she is. If I get these really big moments, that to me, I think, would be great for the candidate. Elizabeth Warren, she doesn't necessarily have to win this debate, but what she does need to do in order to come out on top is just maintain, right? Because she's the front runner out of this field when you look at public polling. So she just needs to maintain momentum. She doesn't need to do amazing or perform exceptionally well. She just can't faceplant because that could hurt her. For a candidate like Tulsi Gabbard, this has to be her moment. She's got to have a breakout moment. And I hope that she's aggressive. And I know that that necessarily isn't her demeanor because she's more calm, but she's got to be forceful. And there's 10 candidates on the stage. She's got to force her way, you know, into conversation. She's got to make sure that people know who she is. When it comes to Cory Booker, I'd say this also needs to be a breakout night for him. Same with Julian Castro. They have enough policies to where they could frame themselves as progressives. I don't necessarily think that would be persuasive. However, the general public may buy it. When it comes to Beto O'Rourke, this really is make or break. If he doesn't have a breakout moment tonight, I think he's done. Because he's already admitted that his campaign is struggling. He had to do a relaunch and had a slight bump in the polls. And then he's back down. This has got to be a breakout for Beto O'Rourke. Otherwise, I just don't think he's going to have enough momentum to even make it past Iowa very far. You know, so this really is a huge moment. People who I think will probably be overlooked and not have much of a presence. Tim Ryan, I don't even know what he stands for. So he's got to make his presence known in a really substantial way and have one signature issue. Like, we already expect Tulsi Gabbard to come out swinging when it comes to foreign policy. And additionally, we expect Elizabeth Warren to come out with really good domestic policy proposals. I don't know what to expect from Tim Ryan. So he's got to really put up. Otherwise, I don't see how he can, you know, have the momentum to continue. Jay Inslee, here's the thing with Jay Inslee, and this is his problem. He made climate change his signature policy proposal. The thing is that it's going to be very difficult for him to break out because his passion when it comes to climate change, even if that's admirable, I think that Elizabeth Warren, Tulsi Gabbard, even Bill de Blasio, they can very persuasively make the case that they're as equally passionate about it. And they all have more name recognition. So I'm going to find it difficult to imagine a scenario where Jay Inslee has a breakout moment, but maybe he can set himself apart because that's going to be tough. It's going to be tough. You know, with foreign policy, Tulsi Gabbard has a very persuasive case to be made as to why she's the best. When it comes to regulating Wall Street, Elizabeth Warren has the same case. When it comes to climate change, you know, Jay Inslee is not a national figure, and there are other candidates who are also great on this, so it's going to be tough for him. I don't know if he can pull it off, but we'll see. When it comes to Amy Klobuchar, I mean, I'm not sure what to expect from Amy Klobuchar. And the best that we can hope for when it comes to Amy Klobuchar is that she overshadows John Delaney, who is, he's basically in the same camp as her, but I think he's worse because he's actually going out of his way to attack policies like Medicare for All, which are extremely popular, and that hurts the cause for Medicare for All. So even if she doesn't agree, she's at least politically astute enough to know to be quiet about her criticisms with regard to Medicare for All. So I think that what we're going to see is probably John Delaney get canceled out by Amy Klobuchar, although he could just be a better debate performer. So it's difficult to predict. Bill de Blasio, I think he's going to try to position himself as the progressive. He's going to try to outshine Elizabeth Warren. I don't think people are going to buy it. So I'm not going to keep, you know, talking about this too long because the debate is in a couple of hours. Let's all tune in. I certainly will. And you could expect my post-debate analysis about an hour or two after the debate. I will be posting that tonight. It may get out, you know, at midnight, but nonetheless, it will be out. Here's how I'm going to be analyzing the debate. I'm going to pick who I think won based on performance overall. Then I'm going to tell you who I liked based on policy. Spoiler alert, it's going to be Elizabeth Warren and Tulsi Gabbard. That's probably going to hinge on who got the most time to talk. And then I'm going to talk about, you know, who had a breakout moment that could help them. And we'll talk about the losers because, you know, I love talking about the losers because there's quite a bit of losers on this stage. So I'm looking forward to it. And I will be live tweeting the debate. I'm not going to film it or stream it because I think it would be difficult for me to mute my criticism and reactions because I just have a big mouth and I won't be able to shut up. And I think that would ruin the experience for other people. So I will post a follow-up video once it's done, and we'll all go from there. I'm excited, though.
Thank you.